If you think lasers are too expensive, too big, and too complicated, I would generally agree. Over the last 8 years, I've had 6 different laser cutters. And for the first time, I can confidently recommend what could be your first one, especially if you don't consider yourself a digital maker. This is the WeCreat Vision, and they've done a very good job of removing most of the barriers of getting into laser cutting and engraving. So for the first half of the video, I'm gonna go over why this should be your first laser, and the second half of the video, we're gonna make some cool stuff. Check it. So one, right off the bat, let's talk about the price. $1,199.99. Now, that's a lot of money, but for what this machine can do, I think that is a very, very good price. In comparison, the X-Tool P2 video that we just put out a couple weeks ago, that machine starts at $4,500, and then my RayJet R400 starts at $10,000. So in comparison, this is much cheaper, and I believe that's a sale price, so that may change. 90% of what I do on this machine, I can do on the WeCreat. And for $200 more, you can get the rotary attachment. In my 8 years of laser cutting, I have never used one, so today's gonna be a first. Size, the outside dimensions are 589 millimeters by 531 with a working area of 420 by 290. To some, that might seem small, but I think in this case, it's an advantage. It's marketed to be used inside the house, in an office, and desktop lasers are typically huge. My X-Tool P2, it's a desktop laser, but it takes up a lot of space. You might not have a lot of space in your office. That's where I think the size is an advantage for this guy. You don't need any other software. It comes with an app called Make It, and it's got text tools, basic drawing tools, and shapes. You can do everything within the app and send it right to the laser. My RayJet R400 doesn't do that. You don't even need an account to use the software. That's very rare these days. And it's not cloud-based, so no internet, no problem. That's not the case with all lasers. Software is pretty easy to use. I got it right away. There's not so many options where you're overwhelmed, but there's enough to do what you need to do. The whole operation, there's only a single button on this machine. Everything is very simple and easy to use. This is definitely marketed to be someone's first laser. Laser cutters create smoke and fumes, so there is an integrated exhaust fan built into the machine so you could run this right out the window. Not all lasers have a fan built in. So this is the fume extractor. It's an extra $600 and it works pretty well. I would say if you have the option to vent out the window instead, save yourself $600. And venting out the window is just a better option for me. It's not perfect. I can still smell some of the fumes, but I've yet to encounter any laser cutter that is absolutely perfect at extracting all the fumes. So inside here, is just a big old filter. I can hear some carbon in there. And then this is all replaceable. It doesn't automatically turn on when the machine is running, so you have to actually manually switch it on. Autofocus, it needs to know the height of your material so it knows where to put the laser. This does it automatically with a laser. My RayJet R400, I have to manually focus it every time. That's a $10,000 laser. This is a $1,200 laser.
Did you say $1,200?
$1,200.
That's nuts.
It is nuts. Auto lifting, this whole unit moves up and down to accommodate different pieces and the rotary tool. Other lasers, you have to get a riser. I've never seen another laser where the whole top moves up and down. It's kind of crazy. It's very futuristic and it's pretty cool. I'm not trying to be a salesman here, but I think for $1,200, you're getting a lot of options, a lot of cool stuff. It can cut and engrave. It's a diode laser. Not all diode lasers cut and engrave. This can do both. It is a very family-friendly and safe machine. It's got an enclosure. Not all diode lasers have the enclosure. When you send the files to the machine, you actually have to get up and press the start button on here to make that happen. That's a pretty common thing on most machines, as well as when you lift up the lid, it automatically stops. The exhaust fan stays on to extract the fumes, but the laser stops, and then you can restart it again by hitting the button. They're marketing this towards family, so kid friendly. It looks nice. It'll look nice in your office. Of course, that's not something you're shopping for in a laser, but if this is going to be in your home, you want it to look nice. I'm considering looking nice one of the reasons you should buy this. What are you gonna do? I like things that look nice. Daniel, you look extra nice today.
Thank you.
I really like the company transparency. So if you go to their YouTube page, they've got a tour of their factory. I mean, I've never seen a factory tour of a Glowforge. I'm just saying, it's nice to know where the machines are coming from, the people that are making them. It just makes it seem more human when you see humans working on the machines. Each machine goes through a series of tests before it is shipped. Mine came with these two test pieces, which shows the cut, an engraving, and even an engraving of a cat. In my 8 years of having lasers, I have never engraved a photo, but this can do that. So this is 3mm plywood, and it cut through that and engraved it just fine. 3mm plywood is 90% of what I use in a laser. Free shipping, which I think is a pretty big deal for something of this size. There's no assembly besides just plugging everything in the back. You can work wirelessly or the USB cable, your choice. They're really active on their YouTube channel. Lots of new videos going up every week. Great tutorials and overviews. It's got a pretty precise camera built into the lid for positioning, which is nice. Common feature in these desktop lasers these days, but it's definitely nice to have. My big $10,000 laser doesn't have a camera built into it. Where I think this is great for the woodworkers is not for making projects on, but you can make little plaques to put on your pieces saying, this was made by me on such and such date. And then you can add little branding pieces to your work. You can customize pieces. You can sell pieces with engraved names on there. It just gives you a few more options as a woodworker. And you can quickly and easily make prototypes. You can make little storage boxes. There are websites where you just say, hey, I want a box that's 2 inches by 5 inches. And then it just spits that out for you. And you cut that up on a laser in minutes. It's pretty common these days to see these digital tools in a wood shop. My brother just brought up a good point for stenciling your woodwork. You can lay down a bunch of tape and then you can cut out the image that you want. You pull that off and then you can spray paint or hand paint your images right on your woodwork and then you remove the mask. It's a really cool trick to add some interest to your woodworking. Like I mentioned earlier, you can do most things within the built-in software. You don't need anything else. This is compatible with Lightburn, which is a pretty popular piece of software for laser cutters. I've never used Lightburn. That's about to change here real soon, but just know that it is compatible with Lightburn. Out of the 6 lasers that I've had or have, this is by far the easiest learning curve. They've removed so many barriers to get into it. They want to make it as easy as possible, and I think they did a really good job with that. So let's put this guy to the test. I want to make a little keepsake box, but I don't want it to look like it was cut with a laser. So we're going to do some tricks. So we're going to make it one layer at a time using some 3mm plywood. So I'm going to throw in my plywood here. I already drew this up in Adobe Illustrator. So I'm going to upload my file, Autofocus. The fume extractor did come with a remote. So we turn that on over to the computer. We're going to hit start and then we press the button. Does that zoom in anymore?
You know it can.
Yeah. Quality of those cuts are phenomenal. We must have dialed in those settings perfect. And I just used their preset 3mm plywood, but there is no burning on there whatsoever. That is a really, really good cut. So after cutting all the walls for the box, we cut what is going to be the lid as well as the bottom. And then I can use one of the cutoffs on the bottom of that lid for this box. Still looks like it was cut on a laser, but we got some tricks. So I'm just gonna glue these up layer by layer. So there's the base. Now we'll glue up our lid. And then this is the bottom of the lid, which will nest right inside the box. I sanded all the edges so they're nice and smooth. That is looking really good. So I got some veneer that I am just going to cut up. We're gonna do something extra fancy for the lid. We'll cut that over on the laser, but these pieces can be cut by hand. I got some spray contact cement. Never heard of this stuff. Gonna give it a shot. It's So that has had time to get a little tacky. Of course, this probably isn't the right glue. This definitely isn't the right glue for this. I'm just having fun. Putting on our side pieces. For the lid, I'm gonna do this fun little star pattern on here, and I'm gonna cut everything out of different colored veneers over on the laser. So now that all the pieces are cut, we're gonna tape everything together and then glue it on the lid. Watch this. Oh, are you kidding me? Look at that. Are you looking at that? I don't even know if you're looking at that. We're gonna use wood glue for this. So I'm gonna put wood glue on both pieces and then let them dry. I told myself I wasn't going to glue on top of my cutting mat. That's how I ruined the last one. So now that the wood glue is set up on both pieces, I should be able to just iron this on. The inside of the box, we're going to flock. It's going to give it a nice fibery feel. It's going to cover up all the plywood edges, and it's going to make it look classy as AF. So that's a two-step process. We'll load up our gun. Don't breathe this stuff in. That came out really good. That doesn't look like it was made with a laser. That looks like it was made by a fine woodworker. You can't trust a review video unless you talk about some cons. So let's go over a couple of things that would make this better. This is a diode laser and not a CO2 laser like the other ones that I have. Diode lasers don't do well with colored acrylic. This will cut black acrylic, maybe some other colors. Diode lasers just don't like colored acrylic. This is a 20 watt diode laser. You can't compare a 20 watt diode laser to a 20 watt CO2 laser. They're just too different. They mean different things, but you are not going to be cutting half inch walnut with this. So, I mean, I'm not cutting half inch walnut with my other lasers, but they can do it. And what I've learned recently is the higher the wattage, the less resolution. So if you're engraving photos and stuff on pieces, you're gonna want something with a little bit less power. This is not a production machine. You're not gonna turn your office into a factory because of the low wattage, but for personal use, for family use, for making cool stuff, this is great. It is not perfect at extracting all the fumes, either out the window or with the fume extractor. But to be fair, I've yet to encounter a laser that is perfect. It's just something you gotta deal with. This is a pretty tall machine. My bench isn't standard desk height. Standard desk height is around 29 to 30 inches. This is 36 inches. So it did make it a little awkward reaching all the way into the bottom. If it was on standard desk height, it would have been a lot better, but just know that this is not something you're gonna wanna put it on a shelf. It needs to be a little bit lower. It did a really good job of engraving into the powder coat of this flask, but it treats each vector separately, so it's not very efficient. Instead of doing from top to bottom, going all the way down, it did one vector, and then it had to go through and do the inside of the A and the E and the G individually. My other lasers don't do that. It just goes from top to bottom and it makes it a lot more efficient. Would I recommend this for somebody who wants to start an Etsy store and sell custom pieces? No, it's a little slow for that. Would I recommend this for a family? Absolutely. Would I recommend it for somebody who just needs a laser to personalize their own personal pieces? Absolutely. This is a great laser. It removes many of the barriers of getting into digital making. I like to do cool stuff with lasers. I made the side table using only a laser.